If you hear scratchy, it's because I'm cleaning my brush off while I'm posing. I can multitask. Wow. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I'm showing you eye swatches and I'm giving you a review on the Lucky Bunny Gluttony Palette. Now, Lucky Bunny Cosmetics is an Australian-based indie brand. This is her third palette. I am now an affiliate with her and this was sent in PR. The other two palettes I paid for with my own hard-earned money. Let me, before I forget, show you the ingredients of this palette. As with her other two, it does not contain any talc. The palette is a combination of mattes and shimmers, and in a minute I will let me show you them. Yes, that was weird English. One of the shades kind of shattered a little bit, but that happens sometimes. So here it is. It's basically a blue color story with some, well, a green and a brown and a purple. And I think it is a very fun color story. And I really like the fact that she kind of does a little something extra in her color stories. In a minute, I will swatch them all on the eyeballs for you. I think I used the Kiko Milano eye base when I swatched. Yeah. And that's going to be, yeah, that's the only thing that is really of interest to name before we start. After the eye swatches, you will see me again and I will give you my final judgment on the palette and tell you how the shades performed while creating a look and if I think that the palette is worth your money. If you want to skip ahead to the review part, you can. There's a timestamp down in the description box. But for now, just grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up, because here comes the eye swatching part. And after that, I will see you again. I am looking a little bit worse for wear. It's because I have actually just finished eye swatching the Yasmin palette and I was like, I'm here anyway, let's just go for it. Let's see if my eyeballs will go for another 16 shades. I think they will. But yeah, I'm going to prime my eyeballs with the Kiko Milano eyeshadow base because it's a little bit more hydrating. I'm not going to use a glitter primer for the shimmers. And this is technically also a first impression because I haven't played with this palette yet. So I'm very, very curious to see how the shades will work and look and all that. I'm not expecting a lot of trouble knowing her formula. Okay, the first shade is a shimmer. It's called Aspen and it is gorgeous. Oh, let's go like, oh, this. Here's the shade Aspen. It's not going to go on top of a glitter primer. I will use a glitter primer in the multiple looks video. But not right now. I'm going to start with a dry and then I'm going to spray. But I will show you how I do that. So let's see what it does. Dry first. It is going on a sticky base. Not a glitter primer, but a sticky eyeshadow base. Ooh, it's pretty. Already covered in glitter, but it's very, very pretty. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you how I spray. So basically I load my brush up with the shade and then I'm going to spray. So I'm not going to go into the shadow with a wet brush because a lot of the shadows don't like it when you do that. Yeah, this shadow, unless it is reacting to the base, which it shouldn't, appears to be not really liking a wetness in the shade, but that's okay because I'm going to use it on top of a glitter primer anyway. But I think that this shade, I don't know, probably benefits from a dry application or a glitter primer. Yeah. Here's the shade called Aspen. It's gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous. The next shade is a matte and it is called Amira. Yes, I know you're almost empty. You have to wait on for just a few seconds and then I can change you. I will be so, so very happy when I don't need to put a battery in the camera anymore. I ordered, I don't know, you can. There are special thingamajingy battery packs that are on power source. And I ordered one. It will save me a lot of hassle. I do have three batteries, but yeah, changing the batteries every half hour is kinda Beige isn't that white, is it? So this shade seems to warp a little bit. So that's probably because my base is maybe a little bit too, I don't know, wet still for this shade. It happens sometimes. Let's see how it blends. Oh, blends very nicely. Here's a shade called Amira. The next shade is called Delta, and it is another shimmer. So, same scene, basically. Dry first and then spray. Very, very pretty. Let's spray. Very, very... Oh, Lord, I'm itchy. Very pretty. The shade called Delta. And it is almost a little bit of a particle-y formula. I don't really know how to explain it otherwise. It's very, very pretty. And as you can see, it's very nice and shiny. It is a shade that will give a lot of fallout, I think. And I think it will benefit greatly from a glitter primer. I think all these shimmers will benefit greatly from a glitter primer. Because just looking at them, they seem to be all the same formula. So the next shade is the shade called Lexi. Which in the corner where you see my finger, it was a little bit broken when I got it. It wasn't really shattered, but just a tiny bit broken. So I pressed it back in the pan. So let's see. Just going to go in gently. But I do pick up quite a lot on the brush. Which I don't mind. I have days where I'm very, very bad at packing on shadow on my lid, and apparently today is one of those days. I don't think I really have shadow packing brushes, do I? Maybe this is one. Let's try this one then. Ah, this is a little bit stiffer, so it's a bit better. Ah, this is better, yeah. So I do have a little bit of patchiness, but that is basically where my eye folds are. And that is probably just, I don't know, user error, I think. Let's blend it a tiny bit. Picking up a little bit more. It is looking patchy now, and I actually think that that is the base that is underneath. Because it wants to stick in some parts, and it does not want to stick in other parts. I think it is the base, though. I am, well, this is, again, this is the first impression, so I'm going to reserve judgment regardless. But here's the shade called Lexi. And I think it is patchy because of the eye base. And if it is, well, just not that great of a shade, we will find out in the looks video, because it is more important how they perform while doing an eye look than packed on quite a dry eyelid, you know. So yeah,
okay,
I have two shimmers now, so no eye base, because yeah, it's all good. The first one is Charlie. The reason I say no eye base is because basically the eye base that I use is more geared towards matte shades then towards shimmers. It's just the way it is. So Charlie is going on the eyeball dry first. Very pretty. And these all seem to have, or at least all three that I used so far, seem to have kind of a, I don't know, almost a white base. Let's see what happens when I spray this one. Let me load up the brush on both sides though. Remove the hair. Yeah, I think it is, because I loaded up the brush now on both sides instead of just one, it's a little bit better. But I think it is because they have kind of a whiter base or a lighter base, that they, if you make a white base too much, it kind of, well, disappears basically. So that then it can kind of look patchy. But if you really load up your brush and then spray a little, it's very pretty. And otherwise, just put it on top of a glitter primer. But here is the shade called Charlie. The next shade is called Tessa. And this is a palette that seems to have more shimmers than mattes. And it looks like the shade Sapphire, which I'm going to swatch in the next round, is a satin. So let's see. Oh yeah, I create fallout. I really loaded up my brush, just so you know. Oh, this is a very pretty color. But again, this one also has that, I don't know, almost, maybe it's just a silvery base, you know? Okay, let's spray. Yeah, you know, I do feel that there is not that much of a difference if I spray them or not. I cannot wait to see how they will perform on top of a glitter primer though. But here is the shade called Tessa. Different shirt, different day, because while editing I found out that I lost the footage of two shades. Fortunately it was the just two shades. Oh yes, I have a shiny face, no makeup, just showered, that's basically it. I'm going to go to the shade Josie, which is basically a teal. I think I was using this brush, wasn't I? Primer is still sticky and it has some kick up in the pan, which I personally very much like. Now, while I really cannot blend with this brush, it does blend out nicely. It looks a little bit patchy, but that's probably because I kind of slapped on the eye base instead of really taking my time, you know. I need to get this edited, people. But I use it in a look and it blends out very, very nicely. And don't forget to check out tomorrow's video or later today. Check out the multiple looks video. Here's the shade called Josie. The next shade called Sapphire is a satin. Let's see if it will work with the same brush. I don't remember what brush I used during the looks though. I think it was a different one, but let's see what it does first. And I think that in the look video I actually used it on top of a glitter prime, but I'm not sure anymore. It has been a while. Okay, let's spray. Yeah, when you spray it, it's a little bit more intense. I don't know, can you see the difference between this part and this part? The base just, it sticks together better. And that's what happened when I put it on top of, I think I put it on top of a glitter primer, but I'm not sure anymore. So yeah, here's the shade called Sapphire. The next shade is another shimmer and it is called Harmony. It's the last blue shimmer of the palette. Cutie, let's spray. Yeah, when I look at this one now, it looks to be benefiting from the spraying. I needed to think how I was going to say that. Just a tad. This is a little bit darker than the other shimmers that I had, with the exception of the satin. So yeah, here's the shade called Harmony and it's very, very pretty. And then we have the only brown in the palette, which is called Brandy, which is a, I don't know, is it a cool tone brown? I think so. For me, this is a very, I want to say unique shade for my skin tone right now, that is. It's almost a contour shade, but then darker. So, pretty cool tone brown. I do really like this color though. And for me, it blends out very, very nicely. So here's the shade called Brandy. I'm looking worse for wear, as they say. Last two shimmers. The first one of those is called Sky. Oh, this is the same type of dusty old pinkish shade that she had in the last palette. Oh, I love these types of shades so much. It's that same icy gray, but then combined with a pink or a lavender. Oh, it's one of my favorites. I don't feel like spraying people. Sorry. Or not. I don't think this shade benefits from spraying that much. I don't think it makes that much of a difference. Oh, gorgeous. The shade called Sky. Okay, the last shade is called Coco. Now, this is the only one who doesn't have that white base in it, or that silvery base. Oh, this is very pretty. Also, it's just dry. I didn't feel like spraying. Here's the shade called Coco. Gorgeous. Gorgeous. Okay, let me kind of give you some additional or initial thoughts because this is also the first impression. Oh, my chair can go up as well. I forgot. Oh, not down. No, I need to go up. I kind of forgot. Am I still in frame? Yeah, something like that, kind of. Okay, so let me give you some initial thoughts. I think that the shimmers will perform best, just as I say, on top of a glitter primer or dry. But if you do want to spray your shimmers, don't overspray. So load up your brush and then spray a tiny bit. I think that will benefit them. What I actually really like, this shade, Josie, kind of reminds me of one of. Is that the shade called Re in the Hasina 2? In the Hasina 2, there's a shade that can go green and it can go blue. And that's basically the same with this. So if you were to pair it with this shade and then here, you will pull in the green more. But if you were to pair this with the bluer shade, it will pull more blue. Same with this one, because if you use this one as a middle shade, this one to blend out as your lighter shade and then pull in the dark blue, I think it will all pull a little bit more blue. And you can very nicely play with that. If you don't want to use the blue to deepen up, you can use the brown to deepen up. So I think that is a very well thought out color combination. Now, the only mattes that you have are the brown, then this one, and this one. So maybe that is a little bit limited. But yeah, you can do a green or a blue or a brown base shade, so basically crease, and then yeah, vary it with the different shimmers. I cannot wait to play with this more. Actually, I'm very curious now also to see how the shade Lexi will perform in the look, because that was basically the only shade that I kind of had a little bit of issues with packing it on and then blending it out. So I'm very curious to see how it will perform in a look, and I will probably use a different eyeshadow base there as well. That is going to be it for this part. Any additional thoughts? And the final thoughts will be right after this part. But I haven't filmed it yet because I want to play with the palette first before I give you my final judgment. So when you will see me, it will be with a nice, beautiful face, probably the Gluttony palette on my eyeballs. And yeah, it will be a few days for me, but just a few seconds for you. So let me just stop right here before the video gets too long. Give you over to my future self so she can kind of give her final judgment on the sin called Gluttony and tell you if she thinks the palette is worth your time and money. Okay, those were the eye swatches, and as I said, now I have a nice face of makeup on again instead of looking like I have been hit in the face by a fairy. But yeah. So the shade Lexi, which is the shade that is kind of, it's a, when it arrived here, it arrived kind of broken. So I repressed it a little bit, pressed it back in the pan. It was the only shade that I had issues with while eye swatching. I have used it on its own in a look, yesterday's look. Yeah, look number one. I used this and it is not the easiest dark blue that I have ever worked with, but it is very workable. I also think that it is because of the eyeshadow base that I'm using now. I am using the Sigma eyeshadow base in the looks videos. That one stays sticky for longer. So what I then want to do is set before I use a shade like this, but that's only with an eyeshadow base that is very sticky. I didn't in the looks video, and I could work with it no problem. I basically just patted it on the eye and then blended it out with, I think it was Josie that I used. If I were to use the Anastasia Beverly Hills eye base, which dries down quicker, is less sticky than the Sigma one, I don't think I will have any problems using this one on its own on a non-set base. So it's just the way that you prefer it. Overall, the mattes work very well. This shade Josie leans more towards the green than towards the blue. I know that I said in the eye swatching part that I thought that this could go either way, and it can, but it has more green in it than blue. So for instance, in the first look that I did with the first look that I did in the multiple looks video, wow, it's very difficult to talk apparently, I wanted a predominantly blue look, and this one pulled a little bit too green. Didn't really matter though, because I dusted a little bit of the darker blue on top, and if you mix the two, you kind of get a lighter version of this shade. So yeah, this is look number two, which is a green look. I really wanted to do that, and the last look that I want to do is here, because I think that this combination will be very, very pretty. Now you can layer the mattes very nicely, which I did in the first and the second look. Today I deepened it up with a combination of the brown and then this one. So first I started with this shade, then I kind of deepened it up a little bit with this one, and then I mixed the brown and this one to get the depth that I was looking for. Overall, I think that the mattes perform very, very well. The shimmers are gorgeous. They lean a little bit icy almost. With, yeah, this, oh, I love a shade like this so, so, so much. So, yeah, this also, but that's just the pop of blue, pop of green that you have. But the other shades lean a little bit more icy. This one is a normal colored shimmer, doesn't have any iciness in it. And this one is just, I cannot wait to try this one on in a looks video, because it will be so, so pretty. But yeah, the shimmer formula in here is largely the same. It's not very, no, there's not really different shimmer formulas in here, with the exception of the fact that there is one satin in here, and that is this shade. This is a gorgeous dark blue shade that I used in the first look as well. It's a gorgeous shade. And I am actually happy that this one is in here, because it's very pretty to put all over the lid. When I want to put something like this all over my lid, I kind of, it just is patchy, and that's the color, and it's probably the brushes and the application. I'm just not very versed in all matte looks with certain colors. I hope that kind of makes sense. So for instance, a blue like this, but also yellows, I kind of struggle with a little bit to put all over the lid. So I'm actually happy that this one is in here, and I also think that it is very pretty if you do this in the crease, then this on your lid, and then I don't know, this in the inner corner or something like that. I don't know, I like the color combination a lot. Overall, I do think that the palette is worth its money. Now, it's an Australian indie brand, as I have said. It retails for, I believe it is $35 Australian, which is roughly 20 euros for me here, 20, 21 euros here, which is not a bad price for this palette at all. So versatility wise, this is the most versatile of the three that she has come out with. And why do I say that? Because the blue, the green shimmer, the blue matte, the green matte, and then the brown matte gives you three color crease options. Well, more if you kind of combine them. Her second palette, which was the Greed palette, you either had, well, basically a purple or a pink crease, and then her first palette you basically had a green crease or what was that other color? Yeah, it was a reddish brown. So basically, yeah, this is in my opinion a little bit more versatile. I actually cannot wait to use them all together. That would be very fun, I think. I feel a palette bingo coming on. But yeah, basically the gist of it is, I think that this palette is worth its money. I'm very happy that it did not disappoint. And I think that is it. Yeah. Do I have any more tips and tricks? Yeah, only for the dark blue shade that I used. Basically, if you have a sticky base and you feel like you have trouble blending it out, try to set it first where you want to blend. If you have a base that dries down a little bit more or is drier to begin with, for instance the ABH or the MAC Paint Pot, you don't need to. You know, you can if you want to, but you don't really need to. Overall, I think that, yeah, it blends out beautifully, guys. Today was again on a sticky base. that I put everything, and it came out exactly the way that I wanted to, which is always a good thing. I think that is going to be it. I feel like I'm rambling, but probably because I'm hungry as well. So I'm going to eat and I'm going to close off this video. The looks video should go online tomorrow. If all goes well, if all goes not well, I will keep you updated on the community page. This is going to be it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you tomorrow for the multiple looks video. Bye guys.